else I gotta say, this guitar is awesome. But not for me. Like, it's just not... It just doesn't really fit me right. Like, okay, normally I play guitar like over here, but it's just, I feel like by the time I'm trying to play up here, I'm all like, and it's like I say, it's not the guitar's fault. The guitar is actually like really, really nice. I think the original price is normally like $129, and I can imagine if I went to a guitar store and picked this up, I'd be like, oh yeah, totally it's worth it. The neck feels great. It's so like soft and, you know, kind of just buttery feeling, and you know the frets look beautiful on the ends. Like I think somebody put a little time into that, and like everything, you know, like if I was going to really play this guitar a lot, I'm coming back to that in a minute, but I would probably put some, you know, put the upgraded tuners on it, because I did that on this one, and it seems like it made the tuning a lot better, and seemed like it was definitely worth the upgrade there. The switch here, this will probably break at some point, but hey, everything breaks eventually. Everything. So these feel really good, but like I say, for me, like I tried playing it here, and then I tried playing it with the strap, which I mean the strap worked, and it actually was a lot better standing up. I ain't gonna lie, because what the problem is, I figured out as far as why it doesn't fit me as well. Why it fits better if I play it over here is that compared to this guitar, even though they both have kind of a different scale length, like this one is kind of, let's say like if I, you know, line them up on the same way, it's kind of like the bridge is a little bit further back, and so it's kind of like it gives me a little bit more room to spread out. This one is a 22 and a half scale length from here to here, which a standard Stratocaster, you know, is 25 and a half, and then like Gibson's, like a Les Paul or SG, are like 24 and three quarters. And so, you know, you already, you know, I've played enough of those to, you know, be used to that, and that not feel too weird, because, you know, it's only, you know, less than an inch less than a Stratocaster. And then this guitar is 23 and three quarters, so it's a 1 inch less than the Gibson. So, I mean, it's different, but still in the round. But this one, being 22.5, that's 3 inches smaller than a Stratocaster. Okay, now that's a lot or not a lot, depending on how you look at it. But when you think about it, basically what that means is whenever you're in your, you know, position down here, say you're in the first open frets or whatever up here, like, your arms are 3 inches closer together. Okay, so everything as you start to play through here is in various degrees of how far off it is from where it would normally be. And that might sound stupid if you don't play guitar, or maybe even if you do, but it's like, you know, you got the muscle memory of, you know, where you're used to things being, and they're not really there. And with that guitar, it almost felt like it may, if anything, make it a little easier for me to play or something. I don't know. Either way, it didn't feel like at any point that it was taken away. This one kind of, to me, a little bit does. Like, I just noticed it just a little bit, that I just feel like I'm fumbling around and missing stuff. And I even went back to the other one, and I did feel like I was playing a lot better on that one. I'm not gonna do that for you right now. I mean, I guess it will be on the rest of this video, but I'm not going to do a direct comparison, because I'd be afraid of the comments below when people were telling me, like, no, dude, you suck either way. And I'd be like, I guess I'll go cry about it, okay? But, but it did for me. But just because not for me, I think, you know, I'll definitely find a good home for it. And, like I say, because it's just really nice. Everything about it looks pretty good. I'll make sure and leave the plastic on the pickups. You should always do that. Remember that. You know, sometimes people like ask me, like, hey man, why does my guitar sound like shit? And I'm like, well, number one, you're not good at playing it. And number two, where's your fucking pickup stickers? That's why you sound like shit. I mean, other than reason number one, that's the main reason. But, yeah, like I say, this is an awesome guitar. If you're already a guitar player, you might want to play this before you purchase it, if you're thinking about it, and then see if the change is too much, if you're already used to it. Now, I would definitely recommend this for somebody younger learning to play, because in that case, they're not already used to it. And I don't think the transition in the opposite directions, I mean, you know, up to a bigger one if they, you know, kept playing, hopefully that, I don't, you know, I think that would be okay. It'd be, a little, you know, a little different. You could start doing that, you know, as soon as they're a little bit, I don't know, you're kind of rambling there. You know what I'm saying? I think that would probably be good. But for me personally, I don't know that I would play this very much, because, like I say, for me, it's just a little weird. And I think, you know, once I put it here, it gets rid of the first problem, which is it being in an awkward position for me. But it still makes it where I feel a little weird. And that doesn't mean that I'm sure if I played it just any amount of time, it just feel normal, but I don't know, just like I said, I got so many other guitars I'd probably pick up first. But, like I said, the fret job is, I mean, it's great. They're pretty beautiful. And, which, back to this guitar, it had pretty bad fret sprout, and I looked it up, and there's like this file you could buy for like $15, but I wanted to do it now, because I wanted to play guitar, because I'd already put the, F1 oil fretboard, and that because that's one of the reasons this gets dried up, is why the fret sprout happens, the wood dries up. So that may have helped a little, but not enough. So I used a bastard file, a 8-inch mill bastard file that I had from some previous what the hell ever, I honestly don't remember, but I used it, and you're like, so yeah, it's out there, yeah, not quite, that's not exactly what I did. Instead, because I didn't have, like, painter's tape, and I didn't feel like getting it, I had some Post-it notes, and if you can see all the little holes in it, every time there's a hole, that's where I would, and I had the strings off, I would put the paper there and find where the fret end was, so that I was holding it upside down or whatever, but then I would sit there and scrape it that way until I was getting close to getting to the wood. And of course, I did botch it and get some place up here by the wood, and I didn't, you know, do it sideways and all the ways you're supposed to. I just got it so that it didn't hurt my fingers when I played. And so, yeah, it looks like crap, I'm sure, if you look at it. But it feels all right. It feels fine. I don't give a shit, you know, like I say. So, my point of that is, this guitar, these fret ends are great. They're great. So, don't take the plastic off of the pickguard, or the pickups, you know, you don't want to take it off.